Hello everyone, myself Kunjal Mehta from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today we are going to discuss about the topic N-channel E-MOSFET. What is E-MOSFET? That is enhancement MOSFET. There are two types of the E-MOSFET. One is N-channel E-MOSFET and another is P-channel E-MOSFET. So let's start with the first type of enhancement MOSFET, that is N-channel. MOSFET full form, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. E-MOSFET, that is enhancement MOSFET. We have studied already the depletion type and enhancement type MOSFETs. Depletion, that is normally closed switch. Enhancement type, that is normally open switch. What is the meaning of normally closed? That is on switch. Okay. And what is the meaning of normally open? That is the off switch. So now, in depletion MOSFET type, we have studied N-channel D-MOSFET and P-channel D-MOSFET. Now it's time to learn about the enhancement MOSFET. Again, there are two types as I have discussed earlier. N-channel E-MOSFET and second, that is P-channel E-MOSFET. Again, I am defining the enhancement type in detail. The transistor requires gate to source voltage, that is denoted by VGS, to switch the device on. And the enhancement mode of MOSFET is equivalent to normally open switch. This is the symbol of E-MOSFET. I have drawn here the symbol of N-channel E-MOSFET as well as P-channel E-MOSFET. It's a general construction and symbolic structure of E-MOSFET symbol. There are three terminals, one drain, two gate, and third source. But the fourth terminal is also very important. It will be the terminal come out from the substrate. Okay, and substrate is always internally connected with the source. So it will be denoted by SS, that means double S. Okay, it is also known as body terminal. So it has four terminals, that is four terminal device. Source, gate, drain, and body terminal, that is substrate terminal. Okay, MOSFET body is usually connected with the source terminal, as I said already. So substrate and source is shown connected together in symbol. So look at this symbol. This is N-channel E-MOSFET and this is P-channel E-MOSFET. Only the difference between the symbol is that the direction of arrow on the source terminal. Look at this. This is the direction of arrow inside the symbol, and we can say this is the direction of arrow on source terminal, that is outside of the symbol. Drain, gate, and source terminal. Here, this is the proper symbol of N-channel E-MOSFET with inside direction of the arrow on the source terminal, right? So after symbol, we will have to understand the construction and working of E-MOSFET. N-channel E-MOSFET construction. Look at this. This is the N-channel E-MOSFET construction. The main body or substrate will be of P-type substrate, okay? This is the main largest region, that is the P-type substrate, and the most important part of construction is that initially there is no channel. Priorly there is no channel. There is no existence of the channel. Look at this. There are two N-doped regions, are heavily doped N-doped region. And we are extending the two terminals drain and source from this, and doped regions through ohmic contacts. These are the black colored metallic contacts. This is the SiO2 layer for isolation of the gate terminal. This is the third terminal, which is known as gate terminal, denoted by G. Okay, dear student, it is very important to remember that gate terminal is insulated by SiO2 layer from the channel or from the substrate. Okay, here we don't have any channel, but after working, the channel can be existed over here. Channel can be created over here, right? Initially, priorly, it is very important there is channel does not exist, or we can say that absence of channel in enhancement type of MOSFET. Other construction will be similar of D-MOSFET. Okay, so again I am repeating that N-channel E-MOSFET consists P-type substrate, okay, and N-type doped regions. N-channel E-MOSFET construction and working cases. Let's discuss about the biasing batteries. One is input battery and another is output battery. So first of all, it is clear that for N-channel E-MOSFET, the output battery is again between drain and source, and it is always positive, which is denoted by VDS. Look at this. This is the VDS and it is positive between drain and source. SS, this is substrate source terminal, which is connected with the source, okay? SS terminal, that is substrate terminal, it is connected with the source and then it is grounded, okay? And the another important battery, it should be connected at the input side, and that is between G and S, between gate and source. So, dear students, in previous construction diagram, I have explained that there is no channel existence, okay? And here, we will connect the battery at the input side, that is positive battery, between gate and source. Gate terminal is positive and negative terminal of the battery is connected with the source. And that's why electrons will be gathered near SiO2 layer. Majority charge carriers electrons are available into N-doped region. Here also N-doped region. Most of the electrons will be gathered over here by attraction of this plus terminal. Similarly, plus means holes will be repelled by this plus battery terminal of VGS, and they will travel in this direction, in opposite direction of this plus battery terminal, and electrons from N-doped regions as well as from P substrate. Obviously, P substrate has few minority carriers will be electrons. Those electrons will be attracted towards this positive terminal of VGS. So, all electrons will be gathered near this plus terminal. Due to this SiO2 layer, small collection of electrons will be created over here, and that creation of electrons is known as channel. All are electrons, so the polarity of electron is N. N means negative. So this is known as induced N channel. I have written here, for mentioning this created channel, electrons attracted to positive gate terminal, and that is known as induced N channel. Okay, region depleted of P-type carriers, and that is holes. So all electrons are gathered and all holes will be repelled from this positive battery terminal. So as shown in this diagram, when VGS is applied and if that VGS is positive, then number of electrons will be collected and they will create the channel. So after explaining this case of positive VGS, I can easily explain you that This is known as the enhanced channel, and that's why the type of this MOSFET is known as enhancement MOSFET. And due to the electrons, this channel is known as N-channel. So the full name of this type is known as N-channel E-MOSFET. Again, let us discuss about the N-channel E-MOSFET working in detail. As VGS is increased beyond the threshold level, the density of free carriers in the induced channel will increase, resulting in an increased level of drain current. So what I am saying, what I want to say, initially there was no channel existence, that means current zero, drain current zero. When plus VGS is applied, more and more number of free electrons will be collected, and due to that new channel will be created and ID will be increased. What is ID? ID, that is drain current. So ID will be increased. So for E-MOSFET, the total fundamental working for ID with respect to graph is reversed. Okay. In D-MOSFET, we have discussed about that ID is going to be reduced according to the polarity of VGS. But here, we are giving the polarity that is positive plus VGS, and due to that, more and more electrons will be gathered, and here the channel will be created, and so that ID will be increased. In N-channel enhancement MOSFET, a lightly doped P substrate is taken and two heavily doped N-type impurities are added into the body. Operation with VGS equal to zero and operation when VGS is positive, those two cases are important for working. Okay, let's continue with the revision of working and construction of E-MOSFET that I have already discussed in this lecture. This is the symbol, the N-channel E-MOSFET. Inside arrow is shown on source terminal, four terminals, drain, gate and source, and the fourth one is substrate. In construction working with two batteries, one is positive, that is always in output side. For N-channel it is positive. And again I am repeating, that is input gate voltage, that is positive. And due to this positive VGS, electrons are gathered and collected and they will create small channel, and due to that drain current will be increased. So that is the revision of N-channel E-MOSFET working. We have discussed two main cases when VGS equal to zero. That's the first case, there is no channel, and when VGS is positive, drain current increases. Okay, N-type channel, zero drain current when absence of VGS voltage or input battery. And operation for case 2, that is VGS is positive, easily you can understand it creates induced channel, conductivity increases and current flows from source to drain through the induced channels. So we can say that channel is enhanced. Thus the drain current is enhanced by positive gate voltage. So it is very important to understand the two working cases. One, VGS equal to zero, there is no channel existence, and so that we can say that ID equal to zero. But when positive VGS is applied, ID increases, and finally the channel is enhanced. That's why the name is N-channel E-MOSFET. So finally, students, the enhancement of N-channel due to positive VGS, it can be also explained by the graph. One, that is input voltage versus current, and another graph, that is output voltage versus current. The current is common, and which current is flowing? ID, that is drain current. ID versus VGS is known as transfer characteristic, and IDS versus VDS, that is known as output characteristic or drain characteristic. Okay. As per the cases, when VGS equal to 0, ID is 0, but as positive VGS increases, ID increases. It can be easily shown by this graph. Okay. And similar, this graph can be also explained using drain characteristic, and in drain characteristic, VGS is increased positively. These are the different examples of VGS 1, 2, 3, 4, ID versus VDS graph. So initially VGS 1, at that time ID equal to IDS as 1. Second example, VGS equal to 2, positive VGS is increased, ID increases. So it will become IDSS2. Like that, VGS is increased positively, ID drain current is also increased. There are three main regions: cutoff region, ohmic region, and saturation region from the plot of characteristic, drain characteristic. Okay. Let's come to the MCQ session. From this topic, we can discuss small important topic. Like the first question is that the MOSFET stands for full form, that is metal oxide semiconductor filled effect transistor. Question 2, the enhancement MOSFET is a normally off MOSFET. Normally open, that means normally off. Question 3, the enhancement type basically termed as normally off MOSFET works only with large positive gate voltage. Okay, it can be realized from the working diagram easily. We are applying the positive gate voltage, and then channel can be enhanced or channel can be created. So N channel E MOSFET will have positive gate voltage. Similarly, the output characteristic of MOSFET is the plot of output characteristic. It is the plot of ID drain versus VDS. So easily you can give the answer, that is ID is the function of VDS, but VGS is the parameter with different value of VGS, VGS 1, 2, 3, 4, positively it will be increased. And the main plot will be ID versus VDS. So from MCQ, very basics and fundamentals can be cleared for the N-channel E-MOSFET. So finally, as a revision point of view, most important point is that N-channel E-MOSFET, we will connect the positive gate voltage for creation of N channel. And due to electrons are collected here and N channel is enhanced, the name of this type is N channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay. So finally, dear students, if you have any doubts, you can ask me anytime from this topic. Okay. Thank you.